This bit, but essentially it's a countrywide campaign. It's about saying, do we want the government to invest millions in this industry, or do we want them to invest it in renewables? And you know, most people we speak to say, actually, you know, that investment should be into renewables, because when this runs out in 20 or 30 years time, we're still going to need renewable sources of energy. And obviously there's climate change, isn't it? And if I really thought it was going to be a little bit to tide over while we develop renewables, you know, I can see that. But what you can see is there are oil companies all across the country and globally poised to pounce on this as the next money-making thing. You know, there are countries like Germany, they don't even need energy. They make so much themselves, and they've got fracking companies trying to get in there, because there are so many powerful oil connections in our government and in all the other governments, with great lobbying power, more lobbying power than renewables. And that's what it's about. And I think it's not going to be just a little bit to tide us over, it's going to be whole scale.
Yeah.
What they're planning is full scale fracking.
Simon Welsh. I'm a Balcombe resident, I'm a poet and a storyteller, and above all, what I want to see in the world is a global awakening that will cause corporations to let go of their stranglehold on the governments of this planet and pull us back from the brink of
As far as the official stories in the media, whether we've been
as far as the
not,
official stories in the media concerned, they want gas, they want shale That's gas right. to hold us up for the next 40 years or so, while we move over potentially to the nuclear age.
Exactly.
And if we can get that from under our own soil, that means we don't have to buy it in from outside. And isn't that a good idea? Take a look at the places in America where fracking has just gone, with all the companies in America that are being sued by individuals and families for loss of water or loss of whatever land. Bubbling up water. There was one family very recently, they got paid $750,000 to relocate, and then the entire family, including two children under seven, had a lifelong gag order put on them, which means they can't speak about the process, they can't speak about the finance, and when people who want to explore this go to the law courts to find records, the gag order means those records have disappeared as well. So all these fracking companies in America saying, there's no claims against us, have a look at the law courts. It's because they've done so many gag order related payouts, and the real information is disappearing.
Told me that the next site was going to be here, which is 4 miles from where I live, so I came to have a look at it. We all have to be voices for the earth. This technology is an ecocidal technology. It's extremely dangerous, and we've got to get the word out. There's a woman in Pennsylvania talking to camera saying, they've killed members of my family, they've killed my pets, my 91-year-old mother can't turn on her tap, I'm sick. Get the word out, please help. She's begging to camera. That was just in April. This is ecocide, it must be stopped. We have to ban it. We've just got to reject it outright in favour of safe, renewable technologies that will give us energy security, it will give us lasting employment, and might give us a chance of being safe, because at the moment we have very little chance of being safe the way we're going with our energy picture. It's insanity.
I had to do something with the education, get the facts out there, and trying to work, I got more and more frustrated, and then basically since then I just decided to paint my company vehicle with this, just purely to sort of take it to places and educate.
All people next to somebody, possibly somebody you don't know, and you'll introduce yourself. Tell them what town you're from. Go ahead. Don't be British on me. Come on.
Basement. Abnormally high death rates in cow herd. Have had water trucked in since the well blew up.
Don't just look at me, do it, ready, end!
Leukemia, daughter headaches, nosebleeds, son idiopathic esophagitis. Raymond Miller, Bruce Phipps, both deceased, two others injured in a blast. Nona Chaboy, property damage including sinkholes and erosion, verbal agreement broken. Lisa Beck and son Sonny, compressor station, glycol dehydration unit.